Dear students, in last classes we talk about different types of set, your empty set, singleton set, finite set and infinite sets. Other types of set is your equal sets. Equal sets. It is a pair of two sets in which every set has same type of elements with respect to their position. Their position will be not clear, but each element will appear like type. I first write definition: a pair of two sets which contain equal number of same elements. A pair of two sets which contain equal number of same elements. I take examples B and C. Your set B contains 1, 2, 3, 4 elements, and your set C contains elements 4, 2, 1, 3. You locate two sets B and C which contains elements, and what are relation between their elements? Their elements are same, but their position is different. Just your in set B, one is first position, but in set B, one is your third position. Similarly, your element 3 in your set B, third position, but in set C, it contains fourth position. Positions are different, but elements are same, and they also have same number of elements, equal number of elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, and in this set C, 1, 2, 3, 4. So two sets have same number of elements and same kind of element. So you write these two sets are equal, and we represent by equal sign. B equal to C means both B and C sets have same number of elements and they are equal to each other. Is it clear? Your next set is equivalent set. In this type of set, two sets have equal number of sets, but sets are different. A pair of two sets have equal number of elements, equal number of elements and different type of elements. I take an example. You take example set E. I write its element 1, 2, 3, 4, and set F contains elements A, B, C, D. Both sets have same number of elements. Set E also contains 4 elements. Set F contains 4 elements, but elements are different. One is not like A, 2 is not like B. Similarly, you say 4 is not like A. We don't write A not equal to B. I cannot compare between A and 1, but both are elements of different set. A is elements of set F and 1 is element of set E, but two sets have same number of elements, and we write number of elements in set E is 4 and number of elements in set F is also 4, but elements are different, so this type of sets are called equivalent set, not equal set. You write both sets E and F have different types of elements, but equal number of elements. So this is represented by the symbol F. This is the symbol of equivalent. So you write, say, all equivalent sets are equal sets. All equal sets are equivalent, but all equivalent sets are not equal. These are characteristics between equivalent and equal set. Thus, we complete your types of sets. Now we come to your exercise 1.2. Exercise 1.2. Your question number 1. Which of the following are examples of null set? Example of null set. So your first definition, first type of your set is empty set, a void set, and null set. The null set contains no elements. Your first question given. Set of odd natural numbers divisible by 2. This is your question. Set of all natural numbers divisible by 2. All of you familiar with natural number? All counting numbers are natural numbers. In this natural number, a odd number divisible by 2. You have different examples. You write 3, 5, 7, and so on. All are your natural numbers, and you find the collection of odd natural numbers divisible by 2. You find set of all natural numbers divisible by 2, so it contains element, so it is not an example of set, null set, because you find elements. We find elements of the set. So it is not an example of null set. It is not an example of a null set. Second, your question is set of even prime number. You find a number which is both even number and prime number. You find our 2 is even number and 2 is also a prime number. so you find an example 2. So this set contains an element 2, so it is not an example of null set. Null set means it does not contain any element. We find an element 2, so it is not an example of null set. It is not an example of null set. Yes, clear? So thus you complete your question number 1. Again I reach your question number 2. Your question number 2 asks finite or infinite set. The set of months of a year. In this question, you decide which is finite or infinite. So first I give your information. Finite sets had countable number of elements and infinite set had uncountable of number of elements. So in this example, you find set of months of a year. So all of you learn name of month your LKG classes and you reach in class 11. So it is very simple for your collection of month of year, and you find all of you learn there are 12 months in a year. So we count 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. Thus, it is a example of finite set. You write a year has 12 months and 12 will be countable. This 12 is countable. I also write 12 is countable. 12 is countable. So this is an example of a finite set. Is it clear? In the sense of finite set, is it clear? You count the number of months by your brother, sister who study in your class 4, 5, 6 and you are very superior among them. So you decide this is an example of your finite set. Next, I take your question number 2. 1, 2, 3. This is a collection of your set and ask your book, is it your finite or infinite? So I told you count. You ask how much, but there is no limitation. You count. You stand in your class and continue to say 1, 2, 3, 4. Your period will be over, class will be over, day will be over, year will be over. There is no given your stoppage. So this is your example of infinite set. We cannot find their limitation. There is no given limitation. It is denoted by your blank, blank, blank. How much blank? How much you count? And you will be angry in this way and say this is an example of your infinite set. We cannot count because there is no limit. So this is an example of your finite set. This is an example of an infinite set. Thus you complete your question number 2 and 3. Similarly, in question number 3 also ask finite or infinite set. Thus you solve question number 3. I next you solve question number 4. Your question number 4 asks, in the following set, whether A or B not, A equal B or not? It is your question. Your first question is A, B, C, D. And your set B is D, C, B, A. So I explain about equal set and equivalent set. In equal sets, a pair of sets have same equal number of elements and same kind of elements. So you have given set A contains A, B, C, D. Your set B contains also D, C, B, A. Sets are like, but their positions are different. It is not a matter where is our element present. Our elements will be like. We have avoided their position. So set A and B contains same type of element. Sets A and B contain equal number of elements and same type. Yes, clear? For equal sets, two sets have contain equal number of elements and same type. We do not consider their position, where they are situated. We should take their like. They are like. Your A will be A, your B will be B, your C will be C, your D will be D. So you write A equal B. Is it clear? So similarly, you solve equal sets. Similarly, I solve your question number 5, which are given in this manner. Question number 5. First, your first question is A contains 2, 3 and B contains X such that X is solution of X square plus 5X plus 6 is 0. We decide these are equal sets. So in this set, you locate set A is written in your roster form and your set B is written in your set builder form. So set B is converted by mathematical calculation in roster form. And our equation is given X square plus 5X plus 6 equal to 0. And we find the value of X by factorization method. All of you know about factorization method. X square plus 2X. No, this will be not factorized by your middle term splitting method. This will be factorized by taking your biquadratic formula. Your B is 5. C is your 6, and we find its discriminant. Your discriminant is 4AC, and you write B square minus 4AC. So you write 25 minus 24 equal to 1. Your discriminant is 1, and we take their LCM is 1. Yes, clear? And find their roots alpha is minus b plus root d by 2a. So minus b plus 1 by 2 into 1 means minus 4 by 2 is minus 2. And your beta is minus b minus root d by 2a. Minus 5 minus 1 2 इंटू 1 माइनस 6 बाई 2 माइनस 3. दस यू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ x इज माइनस 2 एंड माइनस 3. इट मीन्स योर सेट कंटेंस टू एलिमेंट्स माइनस 2 एंड माइनस 3. बट दीज एलिमेंट्स आर नॉट लाइक योर 2 इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम माइनस 2, योर 3 डिफरेंट फ्रॉम माइनस 3. सो ए एंड बी डज नॉट कंटेन सेम टाइप ऑफ एलिमेंट. सो योर सेट ए एंड बी आर नॉट इक्वल. दे कंटेन इक्वल नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स बट डू नॉट कंटेन योर सेम टाइप ऑफ एलिमेंट. सो यू से आवर सेट ए नॉट इक्वल टू सेट बी. इन दिस वे वी डिसाइड द सेट विच इज इक्वल एंड विच आर इक्विवेलेंट. वी से अबाउट दे आर इक्विवेलेंट. यू लोकेट आवर कैलकुलेशन. आवर कैलकुलेशन इज इन दिस मैनर एंड वी फाइंड माइनस 2 माइनस 3. सो आवर सेट ए एंड बी डू नॉट कंटेन इक्वल नंबर ऑफ सेट्स. यू राइट सेट्स ए एंड बी डू नॉट कंटेन सेम टाइप ऑफ एलिमेंट्स. सो सेट्स ए एंड बी आर नॉट इक्वल. सिमिलरली इन दिस वे यू सॉल्व अदर क्वेश्चंस. योर अदर क्वेश्चंस 2 इन योर क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. सिमिलरली योर क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 इक्वल सेट. सो आई सॉल्व योर क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 फॉर यू. क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 योर गिवेन ए सेट एक्स सच दैट एक्स इज ए लेटर इन द वर्ड फॉलो एफ ओ एल एल ओ डब्लू. सेट बी सच दैट वाई सच दैट वाई इज ए लेटर इन द वर्ड उल्फ. तो दिस सेट्स आर गिवेन योर रोस्टर फॉर्म. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू चेंज इन योर रोस्टर फॉर्म. तो योर वर्ड इज फॉलो. तो आई टेल अबाउट रोस्टर फॉर्म. इन रोस्टर फॉर्म एलिमेंट्स आर रिटेन वन टाइम सेपरेटेड बाई कोमा एंड पुट इन मिडिल ब्रैकेट. सो फॉलो विल रिटेन इन दिस मैनर एफ ओ एल डब्लू. वी डू नॉट राइट रिपीटेड वर्ड एफ ओ. हियर इज ओ इज रिपीटेड सो दिस ओ इज नॉट रिटेन. योर एल एल रिपीटेड सो एल नॉट रिटेन. And only I write F O L W. So this is the roster form of follow. Similarly, your set B contains W O L F. And compare the elements. Your W is W O O F F L L. Both A and B sets contain same type of elements, and each elements are like. So A and B are equal sets. Sets A and B contain equal number of same kind of elements. same kind of elements. So sets A and B are equal. Sets A and B are equal. Thus, you solve other type of problem in your exercise, and I hope you will complete your exercise 1.2. If any problem, ask from me. Thank you.